And the sun has come out. It's at least it's not a wet day, so we are in the open 19-2 Postillion State Landor with the hood open, so we shall get a good view of the royal family as they come past us. This is the carriage which is normally used by the Queen on state processions when visiting heads are there. And there are the royal family, and there Princess Anne in that hat with those great feathers flying, and the Queen smiling happily. Prince Charles looking very debonair with that scarlet carnation in his buttonhole. And the crowd are thrilled. See them moving there in the background and pushing and shoving. All very good-humoured stuff. And the coach comes up towards Thames television camera in the mall there, the standard with the squadron of household cavalry riding proudly behind the open postillion landau. State dress for the postillions. And look at the crowd in the background. And hear those cheers. This is an exciting thing to see. Union Jacks waving and excitement. And behind this coach, of course, there will be other coaches and more colour of squadrons of the household cavalry. Prince Philip looking at the crowd, and the Queen laughing and smiling. One of those Philip cracks, no doubt, have been made to the Queen. Princess Anne smiling.
What happens now is that the city police will hold a red cord across the road to stop this royal procession. And then the Lord Mayor, who's waiting now on the pavement, will, Lord Mays that is, will come forward, and he will offer the Queen the hilt of the ceremonial pearl sword. There you can see the policeman with their red cord. The moment the open landau arrives, they'll remove it, but it symbolizes the point at which the sovereign really has to ask permission to come into the city of London. Even William the Conqueror, after he'd won the Battle of Hastings in 1066, had to apply to the city in this way before he was allowed in. There's the sovereign's escort, the Blues and Royals, and the lifeguards. The open landau, which the Queen, Prince Philip, Prince Charles, and Princess Anne are riding, is drawn today by four horses. Normally it's drawn by six greys, but because it has to turn in the rather narrow confines in front of Guildhall a little later on, just these four greys, because six couldn't get round and be able to do the turn. Really a tremendous crowd out here. Of course, it's a lot of office workers, and but people have come down here from the city and from the West End, and the pavements are absolutely packed. Now they draw up in front of the Lord Mayor, Lord Mays, who incidentally has only been Lord Mayor. He was only appointed 9 days ago. And you'll see the ceremonial pearl sword offered, and the Queen has to touch it. When the Queen and the Duke have had a large number of official and unofficial presents to mark this their silver wedding day. Royal household staffs have clubbed together to commission a portrait of Prince Edward, their youngest son, painted by Husef Riddle. They've had silver toast racks given to them from the diplomatic corps, some silver spurs from the Lord Lieutenants, silver trees from the Royal Forestry Society, silver birches and silver firs. Now the ceremony of the sword is now almost over, and of course the Lord Mayor and his aldermen have to get back pretty quickly to Guildhall, because they have to be there, of course, before the Queen and Prince Philip arrive. Well, I was talking about the presents. The Queen and the Duke of Edinburgh have also had some red roses from Lancashire County Council for one of the royal gardens. A master baker in Sidmouth has sent them a cake. And a lot of ordinary people, particularly school children, have sent them hundreds of drawings and paintings and poems. And of course, for the last week, there have been literally sackfuls of telegrams and letters arriving from this country and from all over the world. There is one present that they have received for their silver wedding that's giving the palace just a little bit of a problem at the moment. It came from the president of the Cameroons. It's a baby elephant, and it arrived today. Well, now as the procession passes on down Fleet Street towards Guildhall for this special lunch given by the Lord Mayor and the city.